What's up guys, Joey here, FugaTech, and today we're checking out a neat little camera, what might very well be your entry point into the expansive Fujifilm ecosystem, the X-A7. Checking out the design, we get hints of classic Fuji design language in a more modern looking body, a metallic texture for the top and bottom. On the front face, we get the mount for Fujifilm X lenses, as well as its release button. And as of the time of this video's release, there are actually 30 lenses in Fuji's range. That's an impressive lineup. Up top, we get two dial/shutter combo buttons, one for still photos and one for video. The power button, the dial for switching modes, a hot shoe mount, and the pop-out flash. On the left side, we have the switch that releases the flash, one of two loops for the strap, and a 2.5mm microphone input. Meanwhile, on the right, we have the other loop for the strap, we have a micro HDMI port, and a USB Type-C port, which we use for both charging and data transfer. At the bottom, a 1/4-20 thread for mounting on a tripod or gimbal, and a hatch for the battery and micro SD card. Finally, at the back, we get buttons for drive mode, playback, menu, and display, plus a joystick for navigating through the UI. But the best part here at the back is the nice big 3.5-inch LCD monitor with a 16:9 aspect ratio, which can be flipped out and articulated to different viewing angles, which is a great feature for those of there who like to vlog or take self-portraits. But I think my favorite thing about it is that it's a touchscreen. It's very intuitive to use when you're changing settings, as well as to use along with the new smart menu. The smart menu basically allows you to change certain camera settings while seeing a live preview of what that particular setting will look like. In this example, we can cycle through all the different film simulation modes, which are digital renditions of actual film stock, such as Velvia, Cruvia, Astia, Classic Chrome, Pro-Neg High, Pro-Neg Standard, Monochrome, and Sepia, all of which are staples in Fujifilm cameras. Aside from that, there are a bunch of other features that enrich our shooting experience. The autofocus is very good given that we get a lot of face detect points all across the frame, so we can pretty much pinpoint where exactly the camera's autofocus should go for. And when taking shots of or with people, the face and eye tracking locks on fast and is accurate as well. And for video recording, don't underestimate this guy. We get 4K at 30fps with no crop, which is extremely important for 4K workflows. And because we're using an APS-C sensor, we don't need any more additional crop factor. It's also pretty capable at slow motion, giving us 60fps at full HD and 100fps at HD. And finally, my personal favorite, countdown video. It lets you specify the total duration of the clip you're filming with options ranging from 15 seconds to 30 seconds. This is helpful for things like social media use, where you want to keep your shots as short and concise as possible. And for people like us, we usually like to keep our product B-roll shots at around 15 to 30 seconds. So having a set time limit per clip really helps you dial in exactly what you want to do before you even hit record. Now for quality, both photos and videos turn out great if you know what you're doing. Though the X-A7 does make it really easy even for absolute beginners. The film simulation modes mean that you already have your filters, so to speak. There's a portrait enhancer feature that uses smart color science that gives you beautiful skin tones. The high ISO capability gives you flexibility in low light situations. There's even a built-in light trail mode for those dynamic shots of busy roads. And the autofocus, the face and eye tracking, they all make the process easier for you. And with the 4K video, it's not just that there's no crop. The X-A7's 4K video actually produces a lot of data. In fact, the same amount of data equal to 6K video. So you just get so much detail. And of course, don't forget the fact that we get slow motion in 1080p, it's super vlogger friendly with that articulating screen and external microphone support. So yes, all in all, the X-A7 is surely a solid entry point into the Fujifilm ecosystem, both for beginners or even advanced shooters looking for a B or C camera. It's intuitive and easy to use, but it's also capable of high camera performance both with photos and videos. So if you're interested in getting one for yourself, the X-A7 is priced at 34,990 pesos for the body only, and 40,990 pesos for the body plus the 15-45mm XC kit lens. There's also a limited edition that gives you the 35mm f2 RWR lens instead, priced at 46,990 pesos, which I think might be worth your while. We used that lens for some of our testing and it is amazing. Anyway, let me know what you guys think about the Fujifilm X-A7 in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please do drop a like, subscribe to our channel for more content, hit the bell icon to miss any future uploads, and be sure to visit FugaTech.com for the latest tech news and reviews. This has been Joey, and I'll see you guys in the next one.